done it, Lanny. You've done it.
And now he'll receive the Stanley Cup. And listen to this crowd.
From the NHL store powered by Reebok, I'm Rob Simpson alongside EJ Raddick. How are you, EJ?
I'm well, Rob. How are you?
Very well. We're moving along here in the playoffs. In fact, the second night of the playoffs is behind us, and now we move on to some game twos, including the matchup in Pittsburgh between the Lightning and the Penguins. EJ, we know we will not see Sidney Crosby tonight. What have you heard about from the Penguins camp about Sid the Kid? What's going on there?
We might see him. We'll see him upstairs. Yes. He'll have the headset on like he did in game one. There's really nothing new to report at this point, Rob. It's still very much a day-to-day thing. Crosby has been skating, but they are taking a very cautious approach with him, which I think is really wise. So at this point, Penguins are still without Sidney Crosby, but not so bad in game one.
No.
Get a shutout of the Tampa Bay Lightning and now have a chance to take a 2-0 lead in game two.
Keep it tuned to the BlackBerry All Access channel on NHL.com. We'll hear from the crew at Versus as they preview Game 2 between the Rangers and Capitals. You're watching the BlackBerry All Access pregame show. An everlasting image from previous playoffs are some last hurrahs for longtime veterans who finally get to lift Lord Stanley. Ray Bourque with the Avs in
01.
Yep, he comes to mind. Dave Andrechuk, captain in 04 for the Lightning. He pops into our heads. This year, we have some veterans who aren't exactly at the end of their ropes, but they have been reaching for the ultimate prize for quite a while. Roberto Luongo has been around a while. You can think of Joe Thornton, Patrick Marleau. Mm-hmm. Of course, now both in San Jose together. They've been around 14, 15 years in the league. Maybe Zdeno Chara, but there's actually some other guys that fit the true ilk of veteran who's ready to lift the cup.
Yeah, I would think one guy that comes right to mind for me is Shane Doan, because first of all, I just like him. I think he's a nice guy. He really is a good guy, and he's one of those guys that his teammates really respond to. He leads by example. He's physical. He can score goals. This poor guy hasn't even been out of the first round in his career, a career that dates back to when the Coyotes franchise was in Winnipeg. So Shane Doan is one guy. You'd love to see him raise the cup. That'd be a great moment. And another guy that comes to mind for me also is Saku Koivu. He was the captain of Montreal for many, many years. You remember him. He battled a cancer issue there in Montreal, had the great comeback, and he's still playing well and really been a factor for the Anaheim Ducks. So it'd be nice to see him maybe raise a cup with his buddy there, Teemu Selanne, who won one in 2007. So those are two guys for me.
And Doner's 34. Koivu's 36 years of age. And one more pops into our heads, I think, that slips right in there, a 35-year-old Ryan Smith.
Yeah, he'd be a good one, too.
Captain Canada. Interesting thing about Smith, now with Los Angeles, he's never been on home ice in the first round.
Wow.
Can you believe that?
That's not good.
He's always been one of the lower seeds.
Yeah.
Heading into the postseason. So that would be cool for Ryan Smith as well. Keep it tuned to the BlackBerry All Access channel on NHL.com. Still to come, we'll hear from the morning skates in Washington and Vancouver. You're watching the BlackBerry All Access pregame show. Besides right here at the NHL, there is only one other destination for all your playoff action, and that's at Hockey Central. For a report on tonight's Rangers-Capitals contest, let's toss it to the crew at Versus.
Rob, thank you so much, and welcome to Hockey Central. Bill Patrick, Keith Jones, and Jeremy Roenick here. Looking forward to tonight's game on Versus, the Rangers and Capitals Game 2 from the Verizon Center. Caps took Game 1, 2-1 on the overtime goal by Alex Semin. Question for the Rangers is, how are they going to score goals? Who's going to score them for them?
I have no idea who's going to score them for him, and I don't even know if they know right now. One thing I can tell you is Marian Gaborik has to wake up and score a goal. He hasn't scored one in 11 games, and in the playoffs, you need your best player scoring goals. Dubinsky has to come in. Henrik Lundqvist has got to continue to be the best player in order to have any chance for the New York Rangers to win any games in this series. But I'm telling you what, they are struggling down the stretch scoring goals, and in the playoffs, they're still struggling to score goals, and they're not going very far in that manner.
And Jonesy, is Alex Ovechkin finally acting like the captain that he should be?
Yeah, he's showing great leadership, Bill. Even through the regular season, I thought Alexander Ovechkin put his own numbers aside and brought into the equation a team game. And Alexander Ovechkin certainly had that in Game 1 against the New York Rangers. He's the focus of the Rangers' defense, especially their best defensive defenseman in Mark Stahl. They're going to try to shut him down using Stahl and Girardi. But Ovechkin battled through that. He was physical. He was strong on the puck. He was sound defensively. He set a great example for his teammates. He came came through with a huge goal in the third period and getting the game tied up at 1-1. And Ovechkin just continued to battle through a little bit of adversity as far as being faced with the Rangers' best defensive pair every shift that he was on the ice. A very sound game one from Alexander Ovechkin, and that bodes well for the Washington Capitals.
Okay, we'll see what happens tonight at the Verizon Center. Game two of this best of seven opening round series, the Rangers and Capitals on Versus.
DJ, the Rangers let one get away from them in Washington. It took them two periods to really get their style of play going. What adjustments do the Blue Shirts make for game two?
Got to get more shots. Got to get more pucks to the net. They only had 25 shots in nearly four periods. And do it in a smart way, Rob. Get them to the net. Look for second chance opportunities. Look to create angles. That's really what they have to do in this one.
For a report on this game from Washington, let's toss it up to Kenny Albert.
Here at the Verizon Center in our nation's capital, the New York Rangers finishing up their preparations for game two of their playoff series tonight against the number one seed in the East, the Washington Capitals. Capitals took game one 2-1 on an Alexander Semin goal late in the first overtime period. Capitals stingy defensively. They held the Rangers to only 10 shots over the first two periods. Shot blocking was a key for Washington. They blocked 32 shots in all, led by the young defense tandem of John Carlson and Carl Alsner, who combined to block 14 shots. Carlson asked what is going through his mind when he's about to get in front of the galvanized rubber.
Not good things, but but all you're thinking about is going in your net, so that's the reason you jump in front of it. And you know, it's not a glorious thing to do, but, you know, I think Newby really appreciates it.
It's one of those days where pucks are hitting you, and you just always try to get yourself in front, and guys are just, I think now it's playoffs, guys just throw pucks on net and hope for a good bounce, and so you just try and get in the way.
So the Capitals hope for more of the same tonight on home ice as they look to take a commanding 2-0 lead in this series. From a New York Rangers standpoint, they hope for more offense. Only one goal. It came early in the third period from defenseman Matt Gilroy, who scored only three during the regular season. For the Rangers, it was feast or famine during the regular season, held to just one or two goals many nights, but also scored at least six goals on 10 different occasions this season. Head coach John Tortorella feels that the team needs more big plays at key times against the Capitals tonight in game two.
That's a difference from winning and losing, especially in playoffs, is a big play at a key time. And I'll go a step further. It's not just an offensive play. It may not be a goal. It may be a great block shot. It may be a great save. It may be a great battle won in the neutral zone that turns into a goal.
From a Rangers standpoint, one lineup change tonight. John Tortorella will insert Sean Avery into the lineup. Avery, a healthy scratch in game one. He will replace Matt Zuccarello. Tortorella hoping for some energy on the forecheck from Avery in tonight's game here in Washington. Goaltending matchup, Henrik Lundqvist and Michael Neuvert. Both goaltenders outstanding in game one. Lundqvist helped out by the crossbar twice in the first period. And Neuvert made his NHL playoff debut and was outstanding, allowed just the one Ranger goal. So it's game two tonight here at the Verizon Center. Washington Capitals with a one-game lead in the best of seven series over the New York Rangers.
The Penguins took full advantage of a Tampa Bay club a little light in the experience department in the postseason, but they do have a leadership core that has been there before. Marty St. Louis, Vinny LeCavalier, how does the team bounce back?
Well, I think one thing, Rob, they should really have to do is be more disciplined. They took six minor penalties in the game. When you're giving the other team, in this case the Penguins, opportunities like that, you are not be able to create offense for yourself. So take fewer penalties and solve Marc-Andre Fleury. That would help too.
For a report on this game from Pittsburgh, let's hear from Paul Stagerwall.
Welcome inside the humongous goalie mask here at Consol Energy Center, and I guess you could say it's symbolic considering how humongous Marc-Andre Fleury was in game one of this series against the Tampa Bay Lightning. He's going to have to continue to be greater than great, and for that to happen, the Tampa Bay Lightning are going to have to be much better, put more pressure on him, drop penalties, get on the power play, create even more traffic and havoc around the net. They promised to do that, and the Penguins expect it.
I think they kind of come hard like they did. They're going to use their speed. They're going to trap the zone, and we have to focus on our game plan and make sure we don't try to go one-on-one.
We have to be ready because they're going to be, excited and going at us, you know, throwing everything to the net again. We're going to make sure we play well in our zone, you know, don't give them much, and box out, you know, for Flower and let him see the puck.
With Sidney Crosby missing in action, the Tampa Bay Lightning definitely have the edge in terms of skill and firepower, but they need to take full advantage of that by getting on the power play. The Penguins had 6 power play chances in Game 1. The Lightning had only 1, and that's a double whammy because not only were they not on the power play, but their top skill players don't kill penalties, so they were on the bench too much.
We don't want to spend 12 minutes in the box, and especially so condensed, you know, the end of the first and the entire second period. It does keep our best players on the bench. The stats on TV, we had 44 hits compared to 20-some for them. We came to fight, and we came to put our bodies on the line. But at the same time, when you throw the body that often, you forget the puck sometimes.
Our first 20 minutes, 15 minutes were very good, and as the game went along, though, we kind of lost a little focus and lost a little energy, so we just have to find a way to play 60 minutes and play the way we know we can, and if we do that, we're going to be fine.
Game 2, the first real gut check for the Tampa Bay Lightning. If they lose this game tonight, their odds of winning this series are greatly diminished. If they win, they'll feel very successful, having earned a split and an opportunity to maybe beat the Penguins in this series as they head back to Tampa Bay.